Now, a lot of times as our loved ones get older, you know, we start to notice that they're not hearing so well. Mm-hmm. Now, they may be ignoring us.
Correct.
But, you know, telltale signs like the TV getting really loud, mm-hmm. and things of that nature can be a clue to the family that something's going on.
Correct.
Now, I know from personal experience that, you know, that our loved ones are often resistant, mm-hmm. to seeking treatment. So, what would you suggest to a family that suspects hearing loss and they're trying to get a loved one to go for an exam? How would we go about getting them to see you?
Mm-hmm. The most important thing is for the family to try and be compassionate and encouraging. An individual with hearing loss will often feel embarrassed or possibly have a low self-esteem, at least when it comes to social interactions and communication, things of that nature. So it's important to try to put a positive outlook as to the importance of having their hearing tested to either make sure that their hearing is within normal limits and then possibly consider other avenues as to why they may not be paying attention or following conversations as often as they used to. Mm-hmm. But also that it can be more noticeable if someone is misunderstanding or not being involved in a group conversation, that can be more obvious and possibly more embarrassing than wearing hearing devices either in your ear or behind your ear, mm-hmm. and then hopefully gain back your social activities, right. You know, talking to people and being more confident. I've had many patients or their spouse say to me that almost immediately once someone has worn hearing aids for a few days and goes back into a social situation or meets friends for dinner, the person is more alert and more involved in the conversation, mm-hmm. and not just, you know, sitting to the side and not being involved in what's being said.